it's getting late. Nobody's gonna swipe right on me anyways. I should probably clean up the mess downstairs before I crash for the night. Well, that's fixed. And nothing happened. Did I miss something? I've got to tell Martha about this. No. There's no way this is real. This is... Oh, Jesus. Huh? Whoa! I bet this unlocks that desk in the attic. She died. I've got to tell Martha about this. What now? What? Okay, somebody is definitely fucking with me. Might as well stay busy, though. Not like I'm gonna get any sleep now. So, are you going to explain what the hell's going on? I appreciate being able to crash on your couch last night, but...
Look, I get that this is all really weird, but there are a few things you need to understand. And I promise that it'll all make sense. Or at least it will if you keep an open mind.
Open mind?! My second floor closet door opened a... Well, I don't know, a portal? I was looking at an open field from my second floor. I think my mind is about as open as it's gonna get.
Well, I guess the first thing you should know is that... this is so hard to say.
Well, spit it out then.
Okay, okay! Look, I knew you were going to move into that house. I've kind of been waiting for you for a few years now.
Know that.
I wasn't stalking you. I've been trying to keep an eye on you. You know, so that you were safe. I knew you'd be moving in yesterday because, well, I know some things about your grandmother. Your whole family, actually.
That's some pretty stuff to lay on someone you just met last night.
I know, but just listen. Have you ever wondered why you were adopted? I mean, like, what actually happened to your mom? Or why your dad didn't take you in?
Not really. I was told that my mom died during childbirth. Still had a family.
That was a lie. He did have a family. He had a brother and a sister. And your mom didn't die during childbirth. She was murdered. And she was pregnant with you when it happened.
Holy shit, are you serious? Who told you this? It's not like anyone would have told me if it was true. And even if it is, I'm sure the records would have been buried. How did you find this out?
I was adopted too.
Huh?
After the incident, I was injured pretty bad. A shotgun blast at close range will do that. The doctor said that my amnesia was a result of the trauma, and it took most of my life to recover my memory of what happened.
Wait. Are you saying what I think you're saying?
About 5 years ago, I started to remember things and started searching for answers about what happened. That's when I found out you were alive. That you survived too.
No fucking way. This is impossible.
Daniel, I know it's a lot, but your sister.
No. I can't believe that.
Well, it's true. I was there.
Okay. Okay. Say I choose to believe you. Why did our dad kill my mother and our brother? Seems like a stretch to think he just went nuts one day.
Yeah, it's crazy. Unless you know what good old grandma was up to. Best I can piece it together, she was someone pretty high up in a secret society. And whatever cult she was a part of had her brainwash our father into doing it.
That doesn't make any sense. What purpose could she or they possibly have had to mind control some guy into killing his family?
Well, what little I found out about the cult says that they needed a child to be born from extreme trauma. An act of violence that could force its birth so that the child could act as a vessel for, well, I really don't know. A vessel for something not good. And that child would have to attain maturity before being of use to them.
Mm.
Yeah, you know what today is.
My fucking birthday. Oh, my 18.
Bingo! Why do you think you were finally able to move into Grandma's house yesterday? The very day before your 18th birthday? Because they planned on doing whatever they intended as soon as you were of age.
So, how did you stay off Grandma's radar? I mean, you live next door. How did she not know?
I moved into that house 2 years ago. By then, I knew there was no way she'd recognize me. You weren't born yet, but the last time she came to visit, I was only a year old. So, when I got the house next to hers, I just kept my head down and avoided her as much as I could, while keeping an eye on everything.
Oh man, this is all too much. So, now we're going where? And why are we going to wherever it is that we're going?
I was able to track down where our family was supposedly buried. And, well, there's something I need to see for myself before I know what to do next.
Yeah?
I need to know if our dad is buried there, too.
Fuck.
We're getting close, and I'll get my answers. And yours, real soon. I know this is a lot. Are you okay?
Fuck. I don't know. I always figured something would happen, and my real family would come find me. Just didn't expect it from you.
Daniel, look out! Well, we aren't far from where we need to go. Looks like there's a trail over there that we can take to where the gravesite is.
Alright. Guess we walk from here.
Yeah, it shouldn't be a bad hike. But you go on ahead. I need to grab my bag from the trunk and handle a little something. I'll join you when I'm done.
What? No, we should stick together.
Go on, you big baby. I was going to send you on ahead this whole time. I just need to do this one thing really quick. Alone.
Fine. Whatever. Just be careful. Call me if you need a hand, I guess.
Thanks, but I'll be okay. I promise it won't take long. It'll be worth it. Oh, and one more thing.
Shit, Martha, a gun? Really?
When I first found out about you, I started looking further into the society that Grandma belonged to. I wasn't able to dig up much, but I did find out about a gathering they were having. I managed to find a place to hide and watch, and during the meeting, well, I stole this. It's some kind of relic for them.
Seriously? A relic? It's just a fucking handgun.
I know it looks like it's nothing special, but the way they were handling it, like they were touching Excalibur or something. I want you to take it, just to be safe. I already took it to a gun range and tested it. It works just like a normal gun.
You're joking, right? I've never even held a gun before.
Just take it. I'll feel better knowing you've got something to defend yourself in case those nutjobs come looking for you.
Come from? There's some extra bullets in here, so that's a win. Oh, there's only one lever here. Oh man, I really don't want to have to hunt through the trash.
Station not far from here. I'm pretty sure it's the one that responded to the call the day Dad went crazy. We'll probably have something laying around that'll help us figure out what happened to him.
Guess this is gonna lead us any.
whatever, but this should still be useful. What the fuck do you want from me? What the fuck is going on? Let's get back to Daniel. Make sure he's okay.
Standard to me.
Look here, at the bottom. Mother rushed to hospital and pronounced DOA. Doctors performed emergency C-section and retrieved unborn child who was given into grandmother's care once doctors released him. That's you.
You too. Oldest son deceased. Daughter in critical condition from a single gunshot wound to the torso.
Do you see anything about, you know, him?
Looks like Dad went missing immediately after committing the murders. It says responding officers failed to locate him. There was an open investigation for a while. This is interesting. Could be a lead. Detectives searched the family's home located in the outskirts of Aspen Falls, but found the house abandoned with no sign of the suspect. Isn't that close to here?
Yeah. Does it list an address?
Yeah. 1138 Thoreau Way. Aspen Falls.
That's our house! It's where we should check next, but I never thought I'd end up back there.
Probably from when we smashed through the gate.
Hey, I mean, she got us this far.
20 more minutes and we would have been there.
Okay, so we head to the bar, grab the keys, and sneak our way back here past those things outside. And then we're home free.
Sounds good. I wasn't too excited about hiking through the ass end of nowhere today.
It's just strange, you know?
What's strange?
I mean, this whole town just feels wrong. Where is everybody? Just weird how since we got here, we've seen no sign of life besides those things. Everything looks as though there were people here an hour ago.
Yeah, I'm not trying to dwell on that.
The note said the keys are at the bar, and that's as good a place as any to start looking for clues. In small towns like this, the local bar gets more foot traffic than a church. And usually the owners are fairly well connected. I don't know, maybe that's where everyone went.
Well, no time like the present to check.
My dad was an alcoholic. This was his watering hole?
Probably. The clearest memory I have is the smell of his breath when he would get home. Beer and cigarettes. It was gross, but also kind of comforting.
Weird. But I get that. My adoptive father wasn't a drunk, but I do remember the way he would smell after work. We're good people. Him and my adoptive mom. They were strict. They always showed me love.
Lucky you. I got shuffled around the foster system for years until a family took me in. They weren't the worst people, but I never quite felt at home there. Probably why I got a job as soon as I could and moved out.
You still talk to them?
Holidays mostly, but no, not really. Nobody else thought to come out here and keep up with repairs.
Well, let's get this over with. Looks like the storm's headed back this way, and I'm not in the mood to stand around outside and all that. Ah, Oh, damn.
You made it. I didn't know if she would let you. But you made it.
Who the fuck are you and what are you doing here?
You should ask your sister that.
Martha, what is this? What is he talking about?
Hi, Dad.
What the fuck? What, this fucking corpse is our father?
How long have you been here, Dad?
Depends on what you mean by here. Long time, I suppose. But time is a funny thing here. Seems like I just saw you yesterday, Peanut.
Don't you fucking dare call me that. You lost that privilege when you killed Mom and Mikey. When you tried to kill me.
I never wanted to. She made me. I had no choice.
I mean, Grandma, right? You want me to believe that she forced you to pick up a shotgun and...
I spent so much time regretting it. If I would have known... You know, don't you? I can see it in your eyes. She talks to you, too. It's so hard to block her out.
Marty, what is he saying? I don't understand.
It's nothing.
I've kept her at bay. Out of my mind. I'm old. This house has become my prison.
Look, man, you may be my sperm donor, but I don't know you. And I don't trust a goddamn thing coming out of your mouth.
Son, when your mother told me that we were expecting you, I was overjoyed. Never meant for you to suffer what you've been through.
All my life, I dreamt of meeting you. That someday you'd show up and answer all my questions. Make me feel less alone in the world. And now... Fuck!
Look, you have every right to be angry with me. To hate me. You both do. There's no way I deserve your pity. Or even forgiveness.
Damn right you don't.
The only reason I fought... The only reason I'm still here is to tell you the truth. To warn you.
Warn us? Of what?
Your grandmother. I know you think she's gone, but she isn't. She never has been. She just changed. She's dangerous.
Yeah, Grandma was fucking crazy, but I doubt she was immortal. Sit down. Sit down, or I swear to God I'll put a bullet through your skull.
You'd be doing me a favor, son. No need for the theatrics. I just wanted to give you something that may help. I kept this hidden from your grandma for a long, long time. Now that you're here, I can finally be rid of it.
We don't want your help. And we sure as shit don't need it.
Oh, but you do. Once you set foot in this place, you were put under its curse. You can't leave. Not until you break her grip on this place.
Bullshit! Shit! Come on! Martha, come help me!
It's useless, son.
Martha, a little help here, please!
Oh, Norman. You were always a failure. Even your little tricks to keep me away have failed.
I'll never let you take them.
Martha...
You have no power here! The time has come for you to accept your fate. This is what you were always meant for!
Grandmother isn't what she appears to be. She is only a small part of what is to come. They needed her to complete the summoning.
Summoning? What are you talking about?
The darkness within you. They want to call it out. If they succeed, everything you know and love will be lost.
Who is they? I don't understand any of this.
Who they are isn't important.
It only matters that you don't let them change you.
Where's Martha? Listen, you decrepit old bitch. Tell me where Martha is now, or so help me God. You're done. Where's Martha?
Son. Last piece of the puzzle. All that's left is to close the door on your grandmother, locking her out of this world.
I don't understand.
Of course you understand. You've seen what happened. I tried to fight it. I wasn't strong enough. She took everything from me. Made me into this monster.
It's done. Neither of us can change the past. Ending it here won't solve anything.
I was weak. You aren't. You can still end this and save your sister.
I don't know how to end this. I didn't even know you existed a few days ago, much less that you were alive.
Your grandmother's been using me to keep the doorway open. That's how she can influence this world. And now, I'm gonna close it for good.
You didn't deserve what happened to you. But neither did your family. You could have done something, anything. To try and stop your mother.
It wasn't that simple, son.
Really? Because from where I'm standing, the choice is pretty obvious.
I can't change the past, Daniel.
But you can definitely pay for your sins.